Coming up new at 6:30. Barbara Lee and Carlo, back to you.
All right, we'll see you then. Thanks, Phil. In the meantime, the Occupy Wall Street movement has now come to Oceanside.
Starting at 3 this afternoon, protesters started demonstrating near the Oceanside Pier. News 8's Richard Allen is live in Oceanside with the latest on those protests. Richard?
Well, Carlo and Barbara Lee, at its height, this fledgling Occupy movement here in Oceanside had more than 100 protesters. They started near the pier. They ended up at this Bank of America branch, at one point filling this sidewalk with protests. Of course, they are inspired by the Occupy Wall Street movement. And in speaking to a number of folks out here who showed up, I can tell you their anger is palpable.
Mad as hell, and we're not going to take it anymore. The corporate greed, the lack of understanding, nobody's listening to us.
At the very least, I hope that they achieve education and continue to spread the education among everybody, because that's the most important thing, is letting people know what's truly going on. We want corporatocracy, not a plutocracy.
Now, these dozens and dozens of protesters started off at Mission and Pacific here in Oceanside. They first marched to City Hall, then to this Bank of America branch on Mission in Nevada. Their message is one we've been hearing over and over again these past few weeks. These protesters calling themselves part of the 99%, railing against corporate greed, speaking out against the actions of banks, corporations, and politicians, the 1%, as they put it. Now, this first Occupy Oceanside event was organized through social media, specifically Facebook, urging protesters to create their own signs and show up. At this point, though, this is not a full-fledged Occupy movement with tents and encampments like we saw in San Diego. Folks here showing up for very personal reasons. One man with a 3-year-old son here because he is afraid he's going to lose his house because banks won't work with him to refinance his mortgage. Another woman out here because her 20-year-old son had to drop out of college because the family simply could not afford it. Now, there is clearly a lot of passion here on the streets of Oceanside, and while there's not a clear consensus, at least one protester says she is hopeful these movements across the country will have an impact.
I think when Congressman goes back and went back, they heard the voices, and they're going to think a bit. It's good. This is the first step. This is only the first step. There's many steps to take.
And as far as the Occupy Oceanside movement goes, the next step for that movement will be an organizational meeting next Friday at 5:30 p.m. That'll be held outside the Oceanside Civic Center. And organizers tell me that anyone interested in the Occupy movement is invited to attend that meeting. Carlo and Barbara Lee.
Richard, do you know if those organizers have any plans to set up encampments in Oceanside like we saw in downtown San Diego?
Well, I asked them. They say at this point there are no firm plans to set up tents, to set up encampments like we've seen elsewhere. But they say that is part of next week's organizational meeting. That is one proposal that they will be floating, whether or not to make this more of a permanent occupation like we saw downtown. But that remains to be seen whether or not they'll actually go ahead and run a full-fledged Occupy movement up here in Oceanside.
All right.
Carlo and Barbara Lee.
Richard, thanks.